So good evening students. Today we want to see 9th standard maths. Then this is for English medium. We want to see the first chapter, set language. This is very very easiest chapter. You see the first one. In the first picture you can see trees. In the second one some numbers. In the third one birds. You see the first one, it's a collection of trees. Second one, collection of prime numbers. Not only simply numbers, prime numbers. Third one, collection of birds, flying birds. So, collection of objects based on their characteristic. What is meant by characteristic? First one, trees. Second one, prime numbers. Third one, birds. So they have some characteristic, then only we can accept this as a set. That word characteristic we can mathematically we can say it as well defined. What is well defined? There are trees. So that they are well defined. There are prime numbers. It is well defined. There are flying birds. Well defined. So that we can accept this is a set. So a set is a collection of well defined objects. Suppose if I write 17 here, it is not well defined because no characteristic. So when they have some characteristic, that means there are trees, numbers, birds like that, we can accept this as a set. This is set 1 and this also set and this also set. So, a set is a collection of well-defined objects. That word well-defined is very very important. It plays an important role in this chapter. So, the specific object should belong to the group. If you consider one object, it should belong to this group. Otherwise, it is not a set at all. You can't consider 16 here. You can consider only prime number in this set. So, that object should belong to this group, then only we can say this is a set. And see that last one, definitely it is not a set. We can assert. Because here, no characteristic at all. It is a number, it is a word, it is a tree. You can't consider this as a set. So, a set. It should have some characteristic, then only we can define this as a set. Suppose in this room I can see some set of furniture. It is a set. Set of play materials, set of electronic things such as TV, Xerox machine, then a laptop, computer, this way. So a set is a collection of things, collection of natural numbers, real numbers. In this way, we can say clearly defined a set is a collection of things that should be well defined. Well defined things only we can collect. You see that statement, collection of good students in a class, collection of beautiful flowers in the garden. The word good, beautiful, definitely it's not well defined. How can we say it is well defined? I consider one student to be good. I consider one student to be good and you may not. You can't consider him as a good student. That is natural. I consider one flower to be good and you may not. So the word good, beautiful, if you find in a statement, definitely you can write in the exam. Definitely it is not a set at all. Good, beautiful, the statement indicates they are not at all set. So far we are seeing set. So in the following way we see element and so on. You please read. So now you see this. Here elements of a set. Listed only once irrespective of order. Suppose and we use capital letters to denote set. If you want to denote a set, you are using only capital letters, capital A, capital B, capital C, like that you are using. And the elements are listed irrespective of order. That means 1, 2, 3, 4. This can be written as 3, 4, 1, 2 or in any way. So the order is irrespective. You can write in any way, but you are using here, suppose if you want to write A, B, C, you are using small letters. To denote elements, you use small letters. To denote a set, you use capital letters. And you are using small letters to denote object written within curly bracket. So, this is curly bracket. Here, this one, and you are ending with this curly bracket. Suppose A is an element of B. How you write it? A is an element of B. You are using this symbol. This symbol, it denotes belongs to. Suppose not belongs means you write not belongs or does not belongs to. So you use this symbol for belongs to and this one not belongs to. So if you want to write 2 belongs to A, you can write 2 belongs to A. 2 belongs to the set A. Suppose 5, na? If you write 5, 5 does not belong to the set A. So far you have seen the definition of set and the how it is well defined and the word good and beautiful. Definitely the set is not well defined, and we are using capital letter and small letter and the symbol belongs and not belongs. So in the next class we see some more topic like this. So thank you. If you want to share this video, you can see in the name Gomini Dharmarajan. You please kindly share it to others. Thank you.